Hey guys, I am finally back home here in Tennessee in the shop after a long and grueling 2020 season. Absolutely crazy. Unfortunately, we just finished the last open. We didn't make the Bassmaster Classic, the ultimate goal. But we had a pretty successful year. Best one that I've had yet. Closest I've ever come to making the Classic. I'm 10 years in, going on 11 years, giving it everything I've got. You know, we're just slowly chipping away and getting better and better, but we're just not backing off or going after it with everything we've got. But the highlight by far of 2020 was Santee Cooper. And since being home, I've got to edit those catches from my 25-pound day, day one, leading the Bassmaster Elite Series. That is as good as it gets for us and for me. It's like a dream come true when I have a day like that. And you can hear it in my voice when I'm hooking those first couple fish, because I kind of know what I was on, and if it went to plan, I knew I was going to have a really good day. Had a phenomenal practice. I had two things going. When I first got there, I started punching and I got some big bites. I caught an 8-pounder, shook a few off, changed areas, started getting more bites, shook a bunch of fish off, and then I accidentally caught a 10-pounder out of nowhere, punching. And just an incredible fish, and some of those bites were big. So that was my game plan by far. Punching, hyacinths, mats, or in a certain area, a couple different places in the main lake. But the key spot that almost won the tournament for me was this depression that I found by idling through the back of this creek. It dropped down like 5 feet. It had some grass. I saw it on my Humminbird side imaging. I fished the back of the creek. I had to be back in 10 minutes on the second day of practice before official dark was sort of, we have to be off at a certain time. And so I had 25 minutes. I came back, I put the trolling motor down. I was going through that depression and they schooled. And they were so big that I thought they were, there was nothing in my mind that said they were bass. I was just like, there must be like giant stripers or something in here. I threw the chatterbait at them. I hooked a 6.5+. It came off on that same retrieve, a 5-pounder ate it. I got it in, unhooked it. I was trying to get out of there. I'm like, I'm getting out of here. I'll come and see it tomorrow. I made one more cast, an 8+ pounder ate it 10 feet from the boat. I tried to shake it off. It came off. I wound, and another 6 to 7 pounder was trying to eat the chatterbait all the way back to the boat, and I ripped it out of the water. And I was like, holy cow, this spot is legit. And so the next day I idled around it, saw that it was about a football field. I never touched it, never fished it again. I was just gonna go there in the morning and hope they schooled. And so that's why it took me a little bit to figure it out. I didn't want anyone to see me in there. I knew it wasn't big enough to be out to have even two boats in there. And so I just figured it out. And so day one, no Marshall, I roll straight up in there. I was a late boat, and I caught a good one straight off the bat. And that's why you hear my voice and my breath. I'm excited because I'm thinking, if I can get this going and then the punch deal going, I have a legitimate shot to win this thing. And I end up catching two out of there, and then you see I start heading up and I go punching, and I just have an unbelievable day. The punching setup was by far my key. A rod that I've worked on with Ian Miller for years and years is the Flip Freak Power. It's our punching rod, and that's what allowed me to punch and flip a 1.25 ounce Wu tungsten weight for 4 days straight, or really 7 days, because I did it right through practice, and been able to bring it to the top of that mat and shake it and just have the smoothness and lightness and sensitivity of that rod, because they weren't biting it. I had to just, something weird would happen towards the top and I would set the hook into them. And I've studied punching for the last probably 5 years with every ounce of my body, because I wanted to get better at it. I love the technique, but I wasn't that good at it as far as landing fish. And now, Ona Jungle Hook, 4-0, the Wu Tungsten 1.25 weight, Mollux SV Crawler, that was a massive a massive player for me, and I'd gotten so much confidence in it. Molex has been huge, but all these little appendages on it, just move, micro move. And that little me shaking at the top, those little legs was creating to come under that mat and bite it. And that's the thing that I figured out that a lot of guys didn't, was bringing it to the top of the mat and having the patience to shake it, to let them come over and then actually eat it. Shimano Metanium, the super fast retrieve, 8.5 to 1, 50 pound Power Pro Super Slick, straight through, painting the braid black with the marker. And just doing those good lean-in hook sets, and I put everything in the boat on day one, and just had an absolute phenomenal day. So this is what it looks like to have an incredible day on the Bassmaster Elite Series against the best guys in the world and be leading after day one. So appreciate all the support this year. It's been a massive 2020, and look forward to a big 2021. I hope you're enjoying the channel. Hope we have tons more content coming your way. Check it out, 25 pounds, Santee Cooper.
Oh my God, oh my God, oh my God, oh my God.
Please stay on. Please stay on, babe. Please stay on. Please stay on.
Oh yeah, come on baby, come on baby, it's a bass, it's a bass. Oh. Are you kidding? Are you kidding? What is this day? What is happening right now? Oh my God, I can't believe it. Look at this. Look at this, guys. Molex SV Craw. Just punched a giant. It's gotta be 7. Give me, baby. Come on, stay on. Whoosh.
There's 5. Woo. Thanks, mate. Oh, that's the little guy. Mudfish. Oh, no. Frickin' giant one too. That is a monster.
Stay on, baby. Giant. You stay on. Oh my God. Stay on, baby. Yes! That is a Santee tank. I'm done. Oh, Molex SV Craw. Giant. That was rushing it too.